Hello everyone, I am Wala Awagi. I am from the Manhur University, Egypt. I am looking forward to talking with you today about paper entitled as Safety Nursing Practice for Full Control for Patients Post Internal Fixation Surgeries of the Lower Limb. At first, I hope like to thank the organizing committee of the conference IMCCRT 2021 for giving me the opportunity to present my research paper. Also, I would like to welcome all the body in this conference. Introduction: Lower limb fractures pose a significantly challenging pathology for orthopedic surgeons to manage. They often are associated with high energy trauma. Lower limb fractures can lead to severe function deficits and are an important element in the causes of disability and the burden of disease in all world regions. The burden of long bone fracture have impacts on the patient's physical, social, financial, occupational, and psychological health. The management of lower limb fractures adds significantly to the expenses of any healthcare system because of cost of surgery, possible rehospitalization, and the physical rehabilitation of patients. So, the initial evaluation and treatment of the patient must occur simultaneously. In case of fractures happen, the choosing between operative or conservative treatment is still controversial. The conservative treatment may be cast application, braces, splints, and skin or skeletal traction. The operative treatment may be internal fixation, external fixation, and even immediate amputation depending on patient medical condition. Orthopedic surgeries are a common daily health issue. There are currently multiple surgical procedures available for lower limb fractures and internal fixation play a crucial role in this surgery. Hence, overreduction and internal fixation represents the gold standard for the treatment of lower limb fractures and remain an integral part of orthopedic surgery for emergent stabilization. Overreduction and internal fixation surgery of the lower limb aim to stabilize the fractured bone, restoring anatomical alignment, reconstructing the anatomic joint, provide fast soft tissue healing, facilitate bone union, full satisfactory function of the injured extremity, and provide early mobility post-operative. So, early mobilization following the surgery may place patients at increased risk for fall. Fall post-internal fixation surgeries can result in negative outcomes among patients and healthcare providers. The American Nurses Association defined the fall as an unplanned descent to the floor or extension of the floor as trash can or other equipment with or without injury to the patient and occur on an eligible reporting nursing unit. Nurses' safety practices for falls control are essential to patient safety. The World Health Organization defined patient safety as the absence of preventable harm to a patient during the process of health care and the reduction of risk of unnecessary harm associated with health care to an acceptable minimum level. Safety practices for patient postoperative involve immediate measures to promote comfort, safety, and prevent complication as fall, injury, infection, fracture, or life-threatening injury. Hence, full control must be considered by all nurses for provide safety practices post-internal fixation surgery. The full control continues to remain a challenging in health care and a vital component of safe quality care. A successful full control process must include a combination of multiple safety nursing practices as number 1. Assessment of a patient for risk factors that include patient history for fall in the past 3 months, assess the patient mobility on bed and out of the bed, assess the use of an assistive device, check the patient medication. Number 2, universal full precautions that include nurses should orient the patient with the healthcare environment, show the patient the cool light use, place the hospital bed in low position, and the cable bed breaks locked. Ensure that the chair will look when stationary, keep the patient care area uncluttered. Number 3, safe healthcare environment that include safe practice about furniture, bathroom, passes and stairways, floor, lighting, and easy accessible. Number 4, safe nursing activities that include positioning patient in bed post-operatively, sitting standing balance, safe patient ambulation, getting on the chair, getting out of the chair, getting up the stairs safely, getting down the stairs safely. Number 5, safe and proper use of different mobility aid for walking. Nurses should observe independent and safe usage of the assistive device and should ensure that they are fitted properly. Number 6, safe exercise practice. The nurse should instruct the patient to perform isometric and range of motion exercise safely. Number 7, instruction for patient about the safe method of carrying activity of daily living, as the nurse should instruct the patient to wear clothes with a suitable length. Footwear should be fitted properly. Should instruct the patient avoid wearing slippers and wear adaptive footwear. Also, nurses should instruct the patient to use and still grip bars during shower or toilet. Avoid long time bathing to prevent hydrostatic hypotension and use the shower chair. Number 8, safe patient discharge. Nurses should instruct the patient to arrange furniture of the bed of the home. Don't keep a small bed at the home. Remove the sarung rug from the floor. Immediately cleaning up any liquid on the floor. Install grip bars on the bathroom walls. A slip resistant rug is next to the bathtub. A rest toilet seat with armrest should be available. And sit in a firm, straight-backed chair with armrest. And finally, nurses should provide the patient with written discharge instruction to control the fall at home. Consequently, nurses may have the greatest impact on reducing the patient falls. Nurses have the most frequent interaction with patients due to their 24-hour involvement and are constantly monitoring for conditional adjustments. Aim of the study. This study aimed to assess safety nursing practice for fall control for patients post internal fixation surgeries of the lower limb. Methodology. Research design. A descriptive research design was used to collect data in this study. Setting. The study was conducted at inpatient orthopedic units of two hospitals. One, Al-Hadra Orthopedic and Traumatology University Hospital, Alexandria, Egypt. Two, the Manhur National Medical Institute Hospital, Al-Bahira, Egypt. Tool. One tool was used for the study. This tool was developed by the researcher based on literature review. Sociodemographic data sheet was attached to it. The tool was entitled Safety Nursing Practice for Fall Control for Patient Post Internal Fixation Surgeries of the Lower Limb Observational Checklist. This tool includes two main parts. Part 1. This part aimed to collect data related to nurses' sociodemographic. Part 2. Safety Nursing Practice for Fall Control for Patient Post Internal Fixation Surgery of the Lower Limb. Part 2 includes items related to safe nursing practice applied for patient post-internal fixation surgeries of the lower limb as the following. 1. Items related to patient fall risk factors. 2. Items related to universal fall precautions. 3. Items related to safe hospital environment. 4. Items related to safe nursing activities. 5. Items related to safe and proper use of different mobility aids for walking. 6. Items related to safe exercise practice. 7. Items related to safe method of carrying out the activities of daily living. 8. Items related to safe nursing practice applied pre-hospital discharge. And these items mentioned before. Method. The study was conducted according to the following steps. Approval from the ethical committee, Faculty of Nursing, Alexandria University was obtained. An official letter was obtained from the Faculty of Nursing, Alexandria University to the administrative authorities in Al-Hadra Orthopedic and Traumatology University Hospital and the Manhur National Medical Institute Hospital to take their permission to carry out the study after explaining its purpose. An official approval was obtained from the administrative authorities in the identified setting to take permission to carry out the study after explaining its purpose. The developed tool was submitted to a jury of 5 experts in the field of orthopedic surgery and medical surgical nursing, Faculty of Medicine and Nursing, Alexandria University, to assess its content validity. Comments and suggestions were reviewed and the necessary modifications were done. A pilot study was conducted on 10% of the study sample nurses to ascertain the applicability, clarity, and feasibility of the developed tool, and the necessary modifications were done. Those nurses were excluded from the study sample. Each nurse caring for patient post-internal fixation surgery was observed 3 times in different shifts, morning and evening shifts, for each item of practice to assess safe nursing practice for full control at any time in the period between the first post-operative day till discharge. Data were collected throughout a period of 3 months from 13 of June to 5th of October 2020 by the researcher. Results and findings. Firstly, sociodemographic data. In relation to age, this graph reveals that nearly half of nurses were in age group of 35 years to less than 45 years with 42.5%. Regarding the sex, this study shows that the most of the study nurses were females, while the lowest proportion of them were male, and the female represent 88.8%. In relation to their qualification, the current study revealed that the highest proportion of the study nurses had diploma degree with 94.3%. In relation to years of experience, the result shows that the highest proportion of the study nurses has experience from 20 to less than 30 years and from 10 years to less than 20 years, were representing 31.3% and 30% respectively. Concerning the attendance of training program about patient safety, this result illustrated that near 3/4 of the study nurses didn't attend any educational courses or training program. That represent 70% of them. In relation to the total score of the study nurses' practice regarding the patient safety practice were unsatisfactory with 90%. This graph reveals that the descending ranking of practice from the maximum score of nurses' practice was 55.68% for universal full proportion, and the minimum score of nurses' practice was 29.19% for safe exercise practice. Relationship between nurses' practice level and their sociodemographic data. This table illustrates that there are a positive statistical significant relationship between the studied nurses' practice and their level of education, years of experience, and attendance of training program about patient safety. Conclusion. In conclusion, this study illustrated that 90% of nurses had unsatisfactory level of overall practice regarding full control post-internal fixation surgeries. Moreover, the majority of nurses had unsatisfactory practices regarding healthcare environmental safety, safe use of a mobility aid for walking, and safe exercises. Recommendations. Recommendations for nurses. A service education program for nurses to update their knowledge and practices concerning fall control and the quality of care provided for patients post-internal fixation surgeries of the lower limb. Number 2. An update manual procedure about fall control to be available in each orthopedic unit. 3. Regular staff meetings and conferences must be conducted to discuss causes, hazards of fall, and how to control it. 4. Reasons for unsatisfactory practice level about fall control measures among nurses should be considered by supervisors and administrators. Recommendations for patients. Patients and family should be given a clear instructions and education about how to control fall post-internal fixation surgery of the lower limb. 2. Arabic colored illustrated booklet about safe home environment and safe usage of ambulatory assistive devices should be available and distributed for each patient post-internal fixation surgery to control fall. Recommendations for further research. The effect of implementing fall prevention program on fall control for patient post-internal fixation of the lower limb. The effect of implementing nursing guidelines on nurses' practice regarding fall prevention for patient post-internal fixation of the lower limb. Replicate the study on large probability sampling for generalization of the results. Thank you for your kind attention.